Hello, my name is Stephen Diehl, and I teach in the biomed department. And normally I'm teaching photo one and nature photography, but this class, scanners as cameras, is something that was born out of my research with dragonflies. I have been doing a lot of scanning of dragonflies using Epson V700 scanners and noticed the incredible detail as one would expect that these scanners can produce, and started thinking about, well, what if we use other things other than dragonflies, and started some assignments in Photo 1 class and decided that, well, perhaps students might want to study using the scanners for an entire quarter. Some of the assignments that we do have to do with liquids, and you might say liquids on scanners. We protect the scanners with thin sheets of plastic, and we also work with standard things like bird feathers, pine cones, roadkill, whatever we can find and bring in. The seafood assignment is one of our favorites. We get a lot of very interesting images of squids, octopus, lobsters. One student was even photographing live fish, her own pet fish that she managed to keep alive, and they were not destroyed in the process of making this movie. And you just never know what's going to happen and what's going to be coming through the doors and being put on the scanners. I was going to bring my cat so we could have a cat scan, but I didn't make that happen yet. And we're trying other things. The students have 4 weeks to work on their own projects, and we've had some lively discussions today about what we might entice people to do as subject matter in here for those projects. The scanner, which is a camera, it's basically a box light device, as we all know. We probably have them in our own offices or homes. And there's a line of pixels, photoreceptors, that sweep across an area. And the other thing that's unique about this is that the light source is practically in alignment, so it's as though you're taking a photograph with a giant ring light. So it gives you very unusual lighting. There's practically no shadowing at all. The other thing that's interesting about the process is that you can actually move the object while the scanning is taking place and elongate or create some very interesting special effects while the scanning is taking. Some students for the self-portraits would lay their head down and roll their head as the scanner went by to create sort of a stretched out look to the photographs. You can get very, very high resolution scans with these. The V700 Epsons are scanning over 6,000 pixels per inch. And we can go in and get documents that are many gigabytes on a large area. So a student or a faculty member or anybody can go in and study a very small area, yet have a huge file that we can present or print from or study. So it has both scientific applications, as we've used in our dragonfly work, or for just artistic reasons, as we're doing here in this class.